I'm just going to put this out there. You've likely never heard of this brand, but you're definitely familiar with this level of performance if you're in the market for a gaming laptop. Can Electronics deliver a superior product, lower prices, and better customer service than mainstream rivals Razer, Gigabyte, and MSI? They sent over their MEC 15G2 so that I could figure it out for myself. If you guys haven't noticed by now, I have a thing for laptops that are actually lappable. I'm not a fan of 2-inch thick 17-pound monster SLI machines with desktop-grade parts in them that give you dead leg after 30 seconds. I'd much rather have my laptops maintain portability with good battery life and decent but not over-the-top specs. The latest round of thin and lights like the 2018 Razer Blade, Gigabyte Aero 15X, and MSI GS65 have really hit the sweet spot for me in terms of performance balanced with form factor and features. The common thread among these laptops has been Intel's newest mobile powerhouse, the i7-8750H, which, with its 6 cores and 12 threads and 4.1 GHz boost frequency, really allows for fantastic gaming experiences and the ability to multitask like a boss. I was in contact with Electronics back in March or April, and while they had laptops that they could have sent out for testing, they really wanted to wait until their MEC 15 got the 8th generation upgrade. And that's what I have here sitting next to me. The other specs that matter here are 16 gigs of 2666 megahertz DDR4, a GTX 1060, and a teeny tiny 128 gig SSD. Of course, most of this is configurable, and that's one of the more interesting things about this small company, the amount of customization you can do when building your machine. Every MEC 15 is hand assembled at the time of order, and not only can you change the usual options like amount of storage and type of screen, but you can also configure memory from 8 to 32 gigs, add in a second M.2 drive of up to 2 terabytes each, plus a 2.5 inch drive up to 4 terabytes, and have Electronics configure your RAID array for you. You can choose the color of your trackpad, up the warranty to 2 or 3 years if you want, and even have their system builders use premium thermal compound during the build process. For a small company that produces a product like a laptop that typically comes in a fairly locked down configuration, there are a huge amount of available options. Overall, pricing is also very reasonable, especially when compared to similar rigs from Gigabyte and MSI. For comparison, you can buy a 2018 Razer Blade right now with 3 different screens, 2 different GPUs, and 2 different storage options. And that's it. That's literally all the changes you can make. Now, the construction of this laptop is another thing that makes it stand out. The outer shell is made almost entirely out of metal with a brushed aluminum lid that kind of swoops down around the sides. I found this to be pleasing to the touch, but the issue with this design is that the end of the lid is actually an exposed metal edge, and it's not actually sharp, but because it's thin and it's a piece of hard material, it's inherently uncomfortable if you accidentally bump into it. The rest of the build is fairly nice, although it does end up feeling a little less premium than something like the Blade, which has a matte finish unibody. At 0.86 inches tall, it's not the absolute thinnest out there, but it's still well within that form factor that I like, and portability is of course excellent. The reason that it's maybe a little meatier than its competition is twofold. One, the interior of the chassis is a little bit more roomy to allow for multiple storage options. And two, the MEC 15 has an actual mechanical keyboard. Electronics touts this as the world's thinnest laptop with a mechanical keyboard, and honestly, I don't doubt it. In fact, I had a conference call with Will, the founder of Electronics, where we talked about their products for a good half hour or 45 minutes, and he was really proud of what they've been able to do here with the keys. The switch design is proprietary, but the mechanism is familiar and the feel is super clicky in the vein of Cherry MX Blues. Granted, the travel distance and the actuation force is far less, but for users sick of standard laptop chiclet keys, this could be the answer. In fact, after using the Mech 15 for about 2 weeks, keystrokes on here started to feel really good, much better than on the Blade. The problem is that the same thing happened that I ran into with my Aero 15 tester, and that's the included number pad. I still adamantly believe that a keyboard on a laptop this size should not have a number pad. It's just too close to the regular keys, and including it means that key spacing is tight and orientation is slightly off-center to compensate. Way too often I found myself hitting the numlock key instead of backspace, having to adjust my typing position, and then having to find home row all over again. Even in speaking with Will, he admitted that this is a problem for some users, but he said it's something that he's gotten used to personally. They wanted to include the number pad so as not to alienate potential business customers, which I suppose does make sense in theory, but this is primarily a gaming laptop, and you would think that maybe they'd focus on that market a little bit more. Below the keyboard is one of the weakest areas of this product, and that's the trackpad. It's honestly pretty bad, and I miss having a glass surface here. This is what laptop trackpads felt like years ago, when all PC users were envious of the MacBook's smooth and accurate glass pane. Again, I spoke with Will about this, and without getting into company secrets, he assured me that fixes or potentially other options are coming, as he understands that this is a pain point for some users. The whole base area is littered with configurable RGB effects, most obvious on the keyboard itself, but also extending down onto a small light strip below the wrist rest. While all of your standard effects are present and the lighting is actually nice and bright and punchy, the transition between colors as it moves around the keyboard is kind of like maybe jerky or choppy, maybe is a better word. It's just not a seamless blending from side to side. It's not like an evolving motion. It's not really a huge deal, but when you're spending this much on a product, I assume you want it to look good. The sides of the base do, of course, have some I/O ports built in. The right side has two USB-A ports and an SD card reader, and the left has one additional USB, headphone and mic jack, and an Ethernet port. You can also see exhaust venting on both sides to aid in both CPU and GPU cooling. While this might be okay for most users, it also might leave you saying, well, is that it? Well, no, it is not, actually. Spin the Mech 15 around and you find not only a power plug location that I really dig, but also a USB 3.1 Type-C port, full-size HDMI, and two mini DisplayPort outputs on the back. There's also more venting here blowing directly off of the two turbine fans, which you can actually catch a glimpse of if you flip the unit upside down. On the bottom, you see a fair amount of mesh that provides intake airflow, as well as passive cooling of the copper heat pipes running between components. Construction of the hinge is a little mediocre. It doesn't feel loose or sloppy at all, but it's not the smoothest, and you can't open the lid without holding the whole thing down. Again, this won't impact performance, but it just kind of speaks to overall build quality and attention to detail. The lid itself features one of the strengths of the Mech 15 and a common thread among this year's crop of thin and light gaming laptops, and that's a 144Hz 1080p IPS screen with great colors, narrow bezels, and low latency. In fact, what I was told is that this is the exact same panel that's used on the Aero 15, and that would explain why I like it so much. I did notice a bit of light bleed coming from the bottom edge and also the top right corner, but this is fairly common in IPS displays, and it wasn't something that was overall very distracting. The 720p webcam is just about the same as you'll find on the Razer Blade. It's nothing earth-shattering, and I really wish companies would take a little more interest in putting a better camera into a $2,000 laptop, but at least this placement is okay. It's at the top of the screen as opposed to the bottom of the screen like the Aero 15 was, where it was shooting directly up your nose and it was basically unusable. This at least is, let's just call it, okay. As the Mech 15 sports the exact same specs as the Gigabyte Aero 15 I recently reviewed, you'd expect it to perform similarly, and it does indeed. Here are some benchmarking results comparing the two. I also threw in results from my GTX 1070 Blade for good measure. We'll be right back. One thing that you didn't see on those slides is a battery life test, and that's because no matter what I tried, I couldn't get the laptop to run the GTX 1060 at full boost on battery. I normally have no trouble with this at all, and even laptops with built-in battery safeguards are fairly easy to bypass by changing a few settings. But no matter what I did here, I couldn't get it to work, so my standard battery rundown torture test was unfortunately off the table. For what it's worth, the battery in here is fairly small at only 46 watt hours. Electronics claims about an hour and a half while gaming and about 5 hours of normal use. In my testing, as with almost every laptop that I've used, I found those numbers to be optimistic. Maybe if you majorly turn down the screen brightness, turn off the keyboard and other lighting effects, and turn off the speakers, you could theoretically hit those numbers, but in fact, in real world scenarios, I only hit about 3 hours and 40 minutes of quote unquote normal use before it auto shut down. This is kind of to be expected from the smaller battery, and Electronics said that they have a much larger battery configuration coming soon to this form factor, so that actually might be a more appealing option for those of you who aren't always tethered to the wall. I will note that while it appears the Mech 15 has a good amount of cooling, it did run consistently warmer than the Aero did, and although the GPU managed to regulate itself fairly well, the CPU throttled really badly during IDA 64 stressing. To be fair, when I spoke with Will, I asked him about this, and he said that their premium thermal upgrade can improve CPU temps by up to 9 degrees. Definitely something to consider. As a result of the high temps though, whenever I ran any kind of strenuous application, the fans ramped up with that trademark laptop turbine whine, and things got pretty loud. It almost drowns out the audio coming from the down-firing speakers, unless you turn up the volume a good amount. These speakers, while suffering from the same partial muddling effect that plagued the Aero's design, still sounded at least passable, although don't count on them for anything more than maybe the occasional YouTube video. They're still facing inherently the wrong way to effectively transmit sound waves to your ears, and I really wish companies would stop considering this a viable alternative to up-firing speaker placement. The Electronics Mech 15 G2 is an interesting alternative to other laptops in its class, although it seems like for everything it does really well, it does a small thing wrong. It performs right up there with the best of them, but it gets pretty hot while doing so. And pure stress shows how weak the standard thermal solution actually is. The metal chassis wrap is a nice touch, but it creates some unnecessarily sharp edges. The mechanical keyboard is a really interesting innovation in a thin and light, but the trackpad is straight up garbage. Connectivity is excellent and uses some great placement, especially for video outputs, but the speakers are mediocre at best. Perhaps the thing that will offset these small problems is the fact that you can basically customize this thing out the wazoo, and generally it will come out cheaper than its competitors. Not to mention that you are supporting a small company that builds all these machines by hand and offers services that really none of the other big companies do, like RAID configurations. Maybe I'm a little biased here, but I got to know Will pretty well via texts, emails, and an extended phone call that touched on a lot of different areas. Every time I brought up an issue that I had with the Mech 15, he said his team was aware of it and was working on a fix. He never tried to argue with me or suggest a different way to use his product. He just acknowledged that yes, this is an issue for at least some percentage of users. And he genuinely seemed concerned about fixing it. Without blowing up his spot or violating any unofficial NDAs, some changes are more, we'll definitely get to that eventually, and some are, we have a new system ready for deployment. It definitely sounded like he and Electronics take user feedback very seriously and are setting out to produce a product that fits the needs of the majority of people with the fewest issues possible. The Mech 15 G2 is definitely a step in the right direction, but for right now, it's almost like two steps forward and one step back. It's a novel approach to selling laptops, but there are definitely still some things that they need to work on. So have you guys heard of Electronics, or would you consider ordering from them? Let me know down below in the comments. Also, don't forget to get subscribed to the channel if you like this kind of content, and consider supporting BPS Customs directly by visiting our merchandise store. That's all brand new stuff. So, as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.